How started the Easter eggs culture on Rockstar Games? How you guys think about to put Easter eggs on the games?
Well, you see, this is a good thing because there was so much freedom and it wasn't like a lot of things weren't really managed. So when somebody thought this could be like a programmer or an artist or a level designer, oh, this would be a fun little Easter egg. They just put it in. Like, obviously, the artist put loads of Easter eggs in. For instance, there's an area in GTA 3 you go into and there's a sign that says, oh, you're not supposed to be in this area. You know, that's just a fun thing. And sometimes the testers would find it and they would say, okay, this is a bit dumb, so maybe take it out again. But most of the time, you know, it was just fun. Then we could all put our put our own ideas as level designers, and all the, you know, the graffiti was like the name of the artist. So that was a little uncool. But other than that, there was not really a rule for it, and people just put fun stuff in, and then you know, if it was good, we let it in there.
You remember the first Easter egg of the GTA series?
Oh yeah, so because you mean GTA 1? I wasn't really involved with that, so I don't really know that much. But in GTA 3, I mean, yeah, there were just like things that sometimes there were just leftover things. Like I wrote another tweet about the moon. If you shoot the moon, it changes size. And I put that in there because the artists weren't sure about the size of the moon. So they wanted to try three different sizes. And then they never decided on a size. So I just kind of left in the thing. It wasn't that I forgot about it. I just felt, this is kind of fun. We'll leave it in and then maybe somebody will find it. And then the testers did find it, but they were happy to sort of let it in there.
Is there any Easter egg that the developers put on the game and the directors of the Rockstar just discovered after the launch?
Not that I can remember, no. But also, it was never a big deal, you know, and sometimes something was left in. You know, as long as it doesn't break the game and as long as people are having fun with it, then it was always fine.
Okay, that's perfect. So, is there any secret of the games, the GTA series, that no one have discovered and only the developers know?
To be honest, no.
No?
There's so many people, like modders and people that've gone over every little detail. Sometimes I watch videos and, you know, I will learn stuff. Oh, I didn't know that, or I didn't know that, or maybe I've forgotten about it. So there really isn't anything that's still hidden, I don't think. For instance, I did the code for the original cheats in the first few games. So, you know, like you go up, down, you get a helicopter or whatever. And then people found different cheats and like new cheats that are forgotten about. So there's definitely people that know more about the game than I do. And I don't think there's anything that's hidden that people don't know about now.
Recently, you made a post on X that revealed a secret about the when you need to find a car and you search for all whole city. And when you find this, just appears a lot of this model on the city. And now, and today I found a meme about it. And I think, I will talk about with the developer that made this. And this is crazy, you know, that this is a famous bug on GTA that call this, right? Yes, can you talk about this, please?
Yeah, sure. A lot of people thought that it was just because it wasn't very good at picking a random car, right? If it was a bug. But it's not really a bug. Of course, what's happened is it only has memory for 8 or so car models. So it loads them in and then it will use it for a while, maybe for a couple of minutes, and then it will replace it and then load in another one. So you always see the same 8 cars for a while, and then they get slowly replaced. So yeah, if you find a car, like obviously often you're looking for a specific car for the car steal missions. When you see one of them, yeah, you'll see many, many of them. And it can be frustrating as a player, but there is nothing, there's nothing we can do about it. There just isn't enough memory to have all the cars in memory all the time.